Well, there is mounting evidence that proves that the coexistence between GM crops and conventional or organic productions is not possible. Actually, the very concept of coexistence is false and misleading. We are talking about living organisms, which once released into the environment, inevitably contaminates neighboring crops, without even talking about all the other steps in the supply chain where contamination can happen. I have two examples which I think are telling. On the one hand, in Spain, in 2009, a peer-reviewed scientific study proved that in the region of Aragon, where most of the GM maize is grown, between 2004 and 2007, so in just 3 years, two-thirds of the organic farmers lost their certification and actually stopped being organic farmers because of the contamination they experienced. On the other hand, the other example is linked to GM rice, a rice that was developed by Bayer to resist an herbicide produced by Bayer, which is actually considered too toxic and has been or is in the process of being phased out in Europe. This rice was field trial only between 1998 and 2001 in the US. Research was stopped and the authorization was not given. After 4 years, in 2006, the same rice was found to have contaminated the international market of long grain rice coming from the US, which actually caused $1.2 billion damages for the US rice industry. Well, Bayer said that it was caused by an act of God, and they are not responsible for that. I therefore have a question which is linked to this issue. If biotech companies claim and are so certain that genetic engineering, genetically modified crops can coexist with non-GM crops, why are they so fiercely against any introduction of liability and redress regimes which would held them responsible in case of GM contaminations? On the other hand, the environmental impacts, the environmental damages of GMOs are also very much proved by a number of evidences in the international literature. Pesticide-producing crops, for example, have been proven to have toxic effects on the so-called non-target organisms, meaning all the other insects which are on the field but are not targeted by the crop, such as butterflies, for example. They also have toxic effects on other beneficial insects. I can give you an example of green lacewings, which are very important to control pests in a natural environment. The toxin produced by these pesticide-producing crops, which is released through the roots also of the plant, stays in the soil, persists, and accumulates there. Another issue is related to the resistance that pests, which are targeted, develop. These insects become increasingly resistant to the toxin released by the plant, and farmers are, after a medium to long term, 3-4 years, are forced to use more pesticides or more toxic pesticides. The same happens with herbicide tolerance crops. These crops, which are 70% of the GM crops grown globally, are causing massive problems with resistance of weeds populations to herbicides. Farmers are now obliged to use more of the same herbicides, spread it more times during the year, and also to use more toxic herbicides, such as 2,4-D, which is the active ingredient of Agent Orange, dicamba or atrazine, all herbicides which in Europe are considered to be too toxic and are banned. In the US, a study that came out last year proved that between 1996 and 2008, the growing of GM crops, mainly soybean and maize, have caused an increase in the spread of herbicides of 170 million tons. And this is clearly a massive environmental but also health problem because of the toxicity of these chemicals. Another problem is also linked to the fact that living organisms being deliberately released into the environment crossbreed with other species. For example, in the United States and in Canada, canola, oilseed rape, have been found to different kind of genetically modified canola actually crossbred and created new species of canola with both characteristics of the different traits that were developed by the biotech industry, and it crossed with varieties in the wild, therefore creating new plants which have never seen before the light and which are not tested, of course. So we don't know whether these plants only got the different traits that the varieties are characteristics have been characterized, or even other characteristics such as new proteins or new toxins being released by the plants. And this is clearly a cause for greater concern on environmental but also on health respects.